It's Aibin Zang from Ishun University and the Università Federale di Rio de Janeiro. Convergence of the 2D Euler alpha to alpha equations in the Dirichlet case in difference to boundary layers.
Thank you, operator. Thank you, Alina, Milton, Jim. And this work joined with Milton, Alina, and Adelis. yesterday, Alina reviewed this model. Okay. This model, we noticed the list of V alpha, U alpha minus alpha squared Laplace U alpha. And this is the boundary condition, the U alpha deletion boundary condition, okay? And omega is the 2D smooth bounded domain. U alpha is velocity, and alpha is positive parameter. Okay? When alpha vanishes, the formula, the equation becomes incompressible Euler equation with the sweep boundary. In this presentation, we will present this prove U alpha go convergence to Euler equation in the L infinity L2 as alpha go to zero. And review by Alina yesterday, Navier-Stokes equation convergent to Euler equation is very hard due to the boundary layer, and this model will prove this convergence, and omega is whole space. We researched and at least in 2010, so prove this classical solution conversion until the maximum existent time of Euler equation. Okay, before state our result, we reviewed this suitable family approximation for initial data. And we call the family is a suitable family approximation for initial data U0. They satisfied four conditions of three. Of course, in our result, prove this proposition that U0H1 is divergence free and tangent to the boundary H1. Okay, then we are construct a suitable family approximation to U0 and the family satisfied three. Then we state the all results, the convergence at alpha go to zero. Fixed time, this global solution, okay? Fixed time, let U lot H3, and with the divergence free and the tangent boundary. Here, U lot is H3, right? And assume that given a suitable family approximation U not alpha in H3 for U not satisfied just the condition three. Suppose U alpha is a unique solution of U alpha. In fact, this solution is unique and global solution. And with the initial velocity U not alpha. And U is the smooth solution of it. Euler equation with the velocity U naught, we conclude this convergence in this sense. Okay. Now we state the global potentness of Euler alpha. This well potentness problem was studied by many authors, which revealed by Alina yesterday. Now we will use the different view prove the global existence. So we applied the cooperate to the first equation in the system one, and direct calculation, we obtain the vorticity formulation of Euler equation described by the four. Okay, define the solution that is a stream function phi. Stream function satisfies the elliptic problem described five stream function. Okay, by Lax-Milgram theorem, we can prove that the existence of a unique solution satisfied this following sentence in the six. Okay. Furthermore, the solution operates Q to V map L2 continuously into H4 and set U equal the operator of K and the first equation of the four. Okay, this first equation be written by this equation. By the fixed point argument, we obtain the global solution and the unique solution. Give the Q0 in L2 and the existence unique power UQ satisfied the following waveform. Moreover, and we have the uniform estimate. Now, I will show this the sketch form of our results. Review by Alina, and we can get the estimate 9, and use this estimate, we can obtain the first bounded and the last bounded. By the interpolation inequality, we get the second bound. Okay, set W alpha is the difference of both solutions, and let the equation 1 subtract the equation 2 and multiply W alpha and integrate space time. We have this inequality 11. Okay, notice the right side of this 11, the third terms, divergent data, like this the diffusion tensor. Okay. So this identity by integral by parts, and the U alpha is vanish on the boundary, and the divergence free. We can prove this identity. We simplify this term like the 12 and split I1, I2, and I3. Okay, we first list the it easy to get this term, mixed term, bounded this guy. Okay, by integration by parts three times, and Lady Jessica encoding, we can obtain this I2 plus I3 bounded by 13. Okay, to estimate the I1, we use the Cato boundary collector function like the UB, great purple GV. Phi is a stream function associated to Euler equation, and J alpha is a counter function supporting data neighborhood of the boundary. We, by calculate directly, we obtain this 14 and 15. Notice that we need this time directive estimate. Okay, when we estimate I1, notice that the make difficult arose from the factor only normal component of U only equation on the vanishing on the boundary, but the tangent tangential component of Euler might be vanishing on the boundary. However, but you Euler equation minus the boundary correction function must vanish on the boundary. Therefore, we can conclusion obtain like this first term spread and minus UB and plus UB from the first term integral by part time and space. We obtain this first term and integral by part the time, we can obtain this initial estimate. And from here, because U Euler equation and minus UB vanish on the boundary, we can obtain this term and this term. But we know Laplace U bar minus UB, great UB, bounded theta minus half. So we obtained this term and this term. So and the second term, second order term, will be bounded k theta 1/2, right? So very simple, we choose theta equal alpha. So we know here, this is alpha minus half, right? So here alpha half. This is half. This is alpha, right? So alpha go to zero. This term go to zero, and this term initial condition go to zero, and this term will go to zero because this alpha great U alpha L2 norm go to zero. So I1 will bounded by this term and this term. So we can get the global one inequality. Very simple, okay? My talk is finished.
Questions?